is important to detach from thoughts and emotions that keep you anchored in the ego's reality. It's important to make use of that opportunity in every moment. For life is all in your favor. You need not suffer it. You must bring your turbulent mind back into the stillness. Abide in that place. For this is the immovable field of being that never changes, never fluctuates. Everything eventually comes back to this formless silence. Do not engage or identify with the mental chatter. Witness without participating. See it for what it is. This way you do not lose yourself in the conceptual world. You must acquire the ability to understand and trust your deepest self. The experiences that you go through are just the current curriculum, the lessons for you to wake up. Embrace the challenges you've been given. Seek out your true nature. When peace is the path, then peace is the result. Do not allow yourself to fall victim to false expectations that the ego dictates, that life has to show up in the way that it desires. When life shows up in the way that we don't like, we'd suffer. Because we want life to appear in a certain way. So see the illusion for the illusion. That enough holds the power to diffuse it. This way you become the master and you don't buy into yourself or others in ego realities. Look at life as one indivisible whole. You are not the separate thinker of thoughts or the personal doer. There's no such thing as your life or your story, but just life unfolding, creating, witnessing, living itself through you. You don't have a life. Life has you. Everything that happens in life is a part of the unfoldment of your spiritual path. When you recognize this, the ego reality will recede into the background, and divine consciousness will be in the forefront. Refusing to see this results in your perception being co-opted by your ego, which in turn allows you to focus on less important things. Passing things that appear to be external or separate from you. You can at any given moment in time reprogram your subconscious mind and those old patterns of thoughts, your behaviors, by repeating these truths. This will neutralize your beliefs, your behaviors. Learn to give your attention to the truth. Your true self is hiding in plain sight. Do not allow your thoughts and emotions to tell you what you think is true, because they cannot reveal the truth objectively, only what you believe to be true. And when you hold on to the ego programming, you are simply upholding the ego's conceptual reality and your imaginary self that exists in that illusory reality. You, as pure consciousness, need this vehicle in order to experience life. Without a body-mind, there is no experience. It is only when we get caught up in the mind that we lose the grip on reality. Most still orient themselves in this imaginary world, where that false sense of identity becomes the center of the universe. And most people do not realize this. This disassociation is what's considered normal in the collective insanity of the Matrix. We need a revolution of consciousness, a new way of seeing and being that's generated from our deepest, truest self, that which is above and beyond our conditioned thinking mind. It is dysfunctional, it's chaotic, it's stressful, and breeds much conflict in turn robs us of peace, because it's a fiction. Truth cannot be found in the mental world. You will not find reality, only ideas about reality. You can only find truth in the present moment. And this